Hi guys, this is Maverick Paul, the chemistry guru. Now in this video, we want to talk about alpha amino acids in proteins and how to draw the primary structure of proteins. So let's take a look. Now in proteins, we have about 20 alpha amino acids. Now why are they called alpha amino acids is because the reference functional group is my acid functional group. And the first carbon attached to my acid will be the alpha carbon. And I have an amine group attached to my alpha carbon. So this amine group will be called my alpha amino group. So this entire guy will just be my alpha amino acid. Now remembering alpha amino acids is fairly easy. You just need to remember these three positions. Now position one is my amine group, my NH2 group. Then my position two is the carbon with my R group. And my position three is my acid group. Now the only difference between one amino acid and another amino acid is in the R group. So we need to be able to identify my position one, two, and three. And I need to be able to look at my second carbon and identify the R group that is sticking to the second carbon, because I need to make use of this R group to identify the particular amino acid. Okay, let's have some examples. Now in this case, I have three amino acids, ASP. The short form notation of this amino acid is ASP, SER, and VAL. Now the format that is being presented here is a bit different from what we've talked about, but if I know that there are alpha amino acids that I can find in proteins, then I can easily find my position 1, my amine group, my position 2, the carbon with R group, and position 3, which is my acid group. So we do that first to identify the R group sticking out of my second carbon. So my ASP, my amine is here, this is my position 1. Then my carbon is here, this is my position 2. Then this is my position 3. So this is my position 1, 2, and 3. Amine, carbon with R group, and my acid group. And the R group in this case will just be this group here. And I can write down this R group, which is a CH2COOH. Now next for SER, it is essentially the same. Position 1 is my amine group. Position 2 is the carbon of the R group. Then number 3 is my acid group. So now my R group is this. That's sticking out of the second carbon. This is my CH2 and OH. So again, I can put this down. My R group is a CH2OH. Then the last guy, VAL, position 1 is my amine, position 2 is the carbon with the R group, position 3 is my acid group, and then I have this group that's sticking out of the second carbon. This one is a CH, CH3, CH3, so this group that we are highlighting here will be my R group. So I can also write this down. This is a CH group, then attached to two methyl groups. Now once we have the R group, what we can literally do is I can draw back my amino acid. So let me show you what we mean. In this case, if I want to draw back my ASP, and then I know that my R group is a CH2COH, then basically what I do is I just make use of the format that we just memorized earlier. My position 1 is an amine group, position 2 is a carbon with an R group, and position 3 is an acid group. So for ASP, I'll draw it something like this. I write my position 1, which is my NH2. I write my position 2, which is a carbon with a hydrogen and an R group. Later I'll put it in. Usually I will put my R group later because the R group is the one that we need to refer to the question. Then position 3 is my acid group. So it looks something like this. So you notice in this case, again, now this is my number 1, my amine. Number 2 is the carbon with R group. Then position 3 is my acid group. So the R group in this case is here. And I know that for ASP, the R group is a CH2COH. Then I just need to write this out. This is my CH2COOH. And then this will be our ASP. So if I were to highlight the R group, then this will be our ASP. So similarly for SER, what we can do is I just write down my position 1, my amine group. Then my position 2, which is a carbon with a hydrogen and an R group. And position 3, which is our acid group. And my R group, which is a CH2OH, will just be sticking out of the second carbon. So this is my CH2 and OH. So this will be my SER. And then the final example for VAL, the R group is a CH, CH3, CH3. Again, I write down this format. My amine group, my position 1. My carbon with a hydrogen and an R group, which is my position 2. My acid group, which is my position 3. And then the R group in this case is a CH, CH3 bracket 2. So I can put it here, CH, CH3, and then bracket 2. So this will be my VAL. Now, primary structure of proteins is the unique sequence of amino acids joined together by polypeptide bonds to form one continuous chain. So essentially, all these amino acids will join together and then they'll link up with each other forming peptide bonds or amide bonds and then form a very long chain, and this long chain, we call it the primary structure of proteins. Now, the only difference between one protein and another protein is the sequence of my amino acids. So maybe, for example, we have a particular protein where the sequence is ASPSERVAL. I have another protein where the sequence of this amino acid maybe can be SERVALASP. And then all these different sequences will give the proteins its different properties and different function. Now, because my primary structure of protein is just made up of amino acids joined together and all my amino acids follow a fixed format, so what this means is my primary structure will also follow a fixed format, and the template is here. So what we have is my position 1 is my amine, my nitrogen. My position 2 is a carbon with an R group, and position 3 is my acid group, and then this will be part of this continuous chain. And again, the only difference between one part of this chain and another part of this chain is in my R group. So maybe let's try to draw this part of my primary structure. Maybe we want to draw this ASP, SER, and VAL. So these are the three amino acids that we have talked about earlier. So again, it is shown here. Now the R groups for my ASP is CH2COH, the R group for my SER, CH2OH, the R group for my VAL is a CH, CH3 bracket 2. Now, when I want to draw my ASP, SER, VAL, what I can do is I can duplicate this chain. That means I write this standard format 3 times, and then I put in the R group subsequently. So let me show you what I mean. In this case, I want to draw ASP, SER, VAL, so therefore I know that I have 3 amino acids joined together. So what I'll do is I'll just duplicate this chain 1, 2, 3, 3 times. So I will have position 1, N, C, C. This is position 1, 2, 3. Then I do this a second time. This is the second set, 1, 2, 3. And then this is the third set. This is my NCC. So this is the third set. After that, what I do is put in the groups. Remember, my position 1 is the nitrogen, amine group. Position 2 is the carbon with R group. Position 3 is the acid group. Then what I'll do is I'll fill in all the groups first. So what we have here is my position 1 is an amine. Position 2 is a carbon with an R group. Usually R group, we will leave it later because again, it's easier for us to write the continuous chain first. Then after that, we fill in the R group later. So position 3 is my acid group. So this is one set. Then I duplicate this set. Position 1 is an amine. Position 2 is a carbon with a hydrogen and R group. Position 3 is an acid group. Then I duplicate this again. Position 1 is an amine. Position 2 is a hydrogen and R group. Then position 3 is my acid group. So this structure is fixed. That means for any protein, as long as it is a tripeptide, that means 3 amino acids joined together for any protein that you can find, this sequence is exactly the same. The only difference is in the sequence of my R group. So what's my first R group? Then what's my second R group? Then what's my third R group? So we already have the R groups. So we just need to put in the R groups. So the first R group, my ASP, the R group is a CH2COH. So I know that this guy is just a CH2COH, I can put it in, CH2COH. Then the second guy is my SER, the R group is a CH2OH. So I can put in the second group, CH2, and OH, this will be the second R group. Then the third one, VAL, the R group is a CH, CH3, CH3. So I can also put this in, CH, and then this is a CH3, CH3. So I can very easily draw this sequence of my primary structure by duplicating this format. Position 1 is an amine group, position 2 is a carbon with an R group, and then position 3 is an acid group. Alright, I hope you find this video useful. Please like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any burning questions involving H2 chemistry that you want me to clarify, please leave your questions at the comment section below and I'll try to address them in future videos. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.